Morning, guys.
Hope everyone's well. Today I thought I'd change the subject a bit. Get a bit tired of some of the old mobile phones. I'm going to make you all worry and feel scared about carrying those things around with you. I will respond to some of the comments in my last vlog tomorrow, when I've just checked up on my facts and details. So today I thought I'd talk about moving to Spain, tell you how I got here 12 years ago now. I was living and working in Edinburgh in Scotland, and I was in a stage of my life where I was just travelling and working and just enjoying
around and working. And I'd been in Edinburgh for about a year and a half when my housemates suggested that we start learning Spanish, and we went to our cheap Spanish course, mostly paid for by the council. We didn't have to pay very much money, taught by a Japanese woman, believe it or not. So I was taught Spanish by a Japanese woman. Actually, she was only Japanese by birth, and didn't actually speak Japanese. She'd grown up in Peru, so very good. She gave us a good start. But I knew I was determined to learn Spanish, and I had my CDs, and I'd listen to my CD or my mini disc or whatever I had in those days. I don't even think it was maybe an MP3 player. I don't think I've ever owned an MP3 player. So maybe it was a CD Walkman. I don't know. Can't remember now. Anyway, I'd listen to my CD on the bus. I'd do my workbook, and I'd be doing this 5 days a week. So I'd about an hour a day of Spanish, and we get to class on Wednesday, and within the first week I was miles ahead of the class, and my teacher was asking me, what are you doing here? And yeah, I carried on, and I pushed myself to learn Spanish. I was working in IT. I gave that up to work as a waiter, because there was more money during the festival in Edinburgh. And I knew I wanted to come back to Europe. I'd been in France and Portugal, and I really wanted to come to Spain. So I did my TEFL course in Edinburgh for a month, and I met my wife on that course. We were very good, and did nothing. Didn't get together until after the course, so I know what you lot are thinking out there. So my move to Spain was concreted, and she just kind of gave me a bit of direction on where to go. I was in between Madrid and Barcelona. I'd basically decided on Barcelona, and unfortunately she was there from there as well. So we actually moved back here together. Well, actually I moved back before her. I moved into her mum's flat, which she was vacant at the time, and I lived there for about a week or so until my wife came out and joined me. I was on a mission to start looking for a place to live, because me and her had only been together for a few months, and wasn't really ready to live together. And the journey began to find a flat, and soon after we decided that maybe we got on really well and should stay living together. So we did. We lived together and have done for the last 12 years. So there we go. That's that bit. So I'm going to tell you like how we got into Spanish. Obviously, we met in Edinburgh. Our conversations were always in English. We spoke in English. When I got my job here, was teaching English with other English teachers. So they spoke English, I'd speak English all day, I'd speak English all night. And then we go out on a Saturday night with my wife's friends, and all of a sudden it's like, speak Spanish, understand Spanish and have fun. And it was difficult. It was hard work. You pick up a few words, but you don't know the people, you don't know their sense of humour. The language is fast, it's like any conversation. You get a group of people together, it's bouncing around, and really tricky to follow. I remember a Saturday night, I actually went home at 11 o'clock, which for any Brits out there would be a normal time to go home, but remember over here that's a It's just sort of the start of the evening. We'd gone out about 9:30 to have dinner, and as the coffees arrived, I just felt like I'd been working all week, and my Saturday night was now more work. I was sitting there trying to follow a conversation, and I just felt like I was working. So I just said, made my excuses and went home and watched a film or went to bed, I can't remember now. But that really was like, okay, I need to get on with this and learn the language. So I got a bit stroppy and told my wife that I don't want to speak English anymore at home and that we should start speaking Spanish. Initially she was quite resistant because my Spanish was pretty poor, and she wanted to keep her English going. And she found it very weird speaking to me in Spanish, as did I, actually. Speaking to her in Spanish was very strange. I think that's something that comes here in Catalonia, especially, where they speak two languages from birth. They have their friends who they speak to in Catalan, and they have their friends who they speak to in Spanish, and those don't really change. They find it very strange to speak to someone in a different language. So we got through that after about 6 months, and you know, I soon progressed that one-to-one conversations with people were possible. I could understand, follow the conversation, but I wasn't really very interesting. I can imagine I was pretty boring with limited vocabulary and not having a full grasp of the language. So people would soon find other people to talk to, and then, you know, as time develops, you're able to participate in, or at least follow group conversations, even if your interjection or response sometimes is a few minutes late, because you're sitting there, you hear something, and your brain goes into, I've got a good response, here we go, and boom, you bang it out, and they're like, yeah, we've moved on, we're not talking about that anymore. Ah, right, okay. So you persevere, and then it kind of clicks. I don't know, it was just one day I realized that I wasn't trying anymore. I wasn't trying to understand, I wasn't trying to listen. I had to concentrate and listen, but I didn't have to try to understand. I could just let it enter, and I knew it was being said, and I could formulate answers. Unfortunately, that took about 5 years, maybe 4 or 5 years to get to that point, and What really sealed the deal that I knew Spanish was I was starting to have dreams in Spanish. And now I'm taking on a new journey to start speaking Catalan. Obviously, over the last 12 years, my comprehension is pretty good, but it's just getting the confidence to spit it all out again and speak it. So my advice is, if you are learning a language, get stuck in, find the locals, and talk until people walk away and go and find someone else and talk to them. It really is the only way. You can study it all you like, you can read books, but to actually learn the language and for it to really click is to get out there and talk. So I hope wherever you are in the world, don't be afraid, get stuck in, and you won't regret it. It's great. Okay, cheers, have a great day, bye.